Okay, I'm gonna make this video right now. What will happen if we travel, if we can travel at the speed of light, or if we can travel faster than the speed of light? Okay, many people don't really understand this stuff yet. We'll talk about it, so that's why I've decided to just talk on it right now. Okay, I got some free time. So first you need to understand what's light. Okay, what is light? Okay, in your physics textbook, okay, there's what is called photon. How many of you actually understand what photons are? The secondary school teachers don't actually talk to students well about this topic, what photons are, energy quantization. Many teachers don't actually teach their students well about that topic. Okay, so I just want to talk about it right now. Photons are the individual particles of light, okay? Like, for instance, imagine light were to be this kind of band, okay? This band having small particles, okay, that form this band. Those individual particles, okay, small tiny particles, okay, that form the band together is what is called photon, okay? And photon, you can say for short, photon is the individual particle of light, okay? And these photons carry energy, okay? So in physics, we usually work with one. Okay, we usually work with unit quantity. For instance, what is force? Okay, if you want to define joule, okay, you will just pick a unit quantity into consideration. Okay, so in physics, we usually work with units. Okay, one unit quantity. Well, that's what we always work with in physics. Okay, so if that is clear to you, you would then understand why we had to name, why we had to just pay attention to just one photon, which is E equals HF. okay, why we just had to pay attention to just one of the particle. Why didn't we study all particles? Okay, so that's why I'm talking about this joule of it. What's joule? Go and read the textbook and know the definition of joule. Go and read the textbook and know the different definition of newton. Go and read the textbook and know the definition of pascal. Okay, you see, pascal can be defined as the pressure exerted by a body if 1 newton acts on 1 meter square area. So why do we have to do it one all the time? Units all the time, because that is what is necessary. Okay, because from the unit, from the one, you can get bigger stuff. Okay, so the one is like the foundation. On that one, you can build other giant formulas, other giant ideas. That is why in physics you usually work with one. If you study something right now that has to do with a big molecule, in physics we don't accept the big molecule. We just pick what's made of that molecule and we study it and we go forward. That is how it is in physics. Okay, so that is why you usually see units, all the stuff. That's why in physics we pay attention to units, okay, quantities a lot. That's all.